everybody, how's it going? Today, I'm proud to present to you an in-depth look at the 2010 Ferrari California. And this is going to be a full, in-depth tour of the California. We'll start up, show the engine, get an exhaust clip and go over the performance data, and show you a bunch of the features on the interior as well as exterior. And today, I'm at Foreign Cars Italia in Charlotte, North Carolina. And so, without further ado, let's go ahead and start it up, let it run. It's a silver exterior with black leather interior, color contrast diamond stitching found throughout the vehicle. Start the vehicle, then turn the power on, then hit the little red button to start. Beautiful. The steering wheel itself is trimmed in perforated leather, color contrast stitching, as well as carbon fiber. Carbon fiber inlays around the steering wheel and airbag cover here, as well as across the top, housing your LED shift indicator as you saw when I turned the power on the vehicle. The airbag cover is also wrapped in leather. Your horns are embedded in the side bolstering. The California is also the first of the Ferrari vehicles to debut a new 7-speed dual clutch automated manual gearbox. You can shift it automatically with the activation of the auto mode here, reverse, or driving it F1 style by the aluminum paddle shifters mounted behind the steering wheel. Now, I can't quite show it with two hands, but to put it directly into manual mode, you would just click one of the paddles, it would automatically go into first gear, pull both of them towards you to put it back in neutral, and the vehicle also has an auto park function right above the electronic handbrake here, and when the vehicle shut off, automatically parks it or puts it in the parking gear. The new dual clutch transmission in the California, just as an F1 car, allows for rapid, almost instantaneous shifts through the gears, and it performs this without any low speed jerky motions usually found in the older Ferraris with the single clutch automated manual transmission. And so, go ahead and cone the headlights. It does have automatic lights, fog lights, as well as the hazards. The windows are fully automatic. And we're going to check out the exterior, shall we? The California is quite a departure for Ferrari versus its traditional vehicles. It focused a lot more on comfort, practicality, and luxury than a sheer accelerating performer. Also reaffirmed by its retractable metal hardtop. Large wide mouth grille, curvaceous wide front end profile with modest air inlet in the center of the hood. The exterior styling of the California consists of a smooth, sweeping silhouette of lines tapering into a higher rear end with indented side skirts, LED turn signal indicators, side mounted heat extract vents, and the traditional Ferrari shield located on the fenders. This vehicle also comes equipped with a set of 20-inch forged aluminum alloy wheels mounted on high-performance tires with a polished brushed aluminum face and high-gloss painted silver inserting. It also has cross-drilled ventilated Ferrari carbon ceramic Brembo brakes for increased stopping power and performance. Now we're going to put the top down. All you have to do is put your foot on the brake, hit the little button here. instantaneous open-air driving. Comparing the California to other luxury exotic grand tours out there, it definitely has an advantage over the traditional use of the soft top. This gives the driver and passenger the flexibility and ease of riding in the open-air experience and then quickly flipping the top back in cases of inclement weather. The California isn't necessarily a lightweight either. At around 3,800 pounds, most of the excess weight is due to the hardtop. To counterbalance this, Ferrari engineers definitely moved a little bit of the weight around in the vehicle to create a more balanced vehicle. Weighing around 47% in front and 53% in the rear, with almost near perfect weight distribution. You can also see the exterior brake calipers positioned towards the center, further accentuating the idea of creating a more center balance of gravity and a better performer overall. Styling uniqueness of the California is also highlighted, setting itself apart from the rest of the Ferrari pack. You have the lines coming off the heat extract vents in the fenders, blending across the door and tapering into the rear deck, further accentuating the rear's increased height, basically due to the hardtop. Beautiful, sumptuous interior. Automatic rain-sensing windshield wipers. And power heated exterior mirrors. LED tail lamps. Quad polished vertical exhaust tips. And a carbon fiber splash panel in the rear between the turn signal indicators. LED third brake light. You also have rear parking assist, as well as a rear diffuser style bumper for increased aerodynamics. I'm going to pop the hood. The California is powered by Ferrari's 4.3 liter dual overhead cam 32 valve V8. With variable valve timing, as well as direct injection, produces 460 horsepower at 7,750 RPM and 357 foot-pounds of torque at 5,000 RPM. It is rear-wheel drive with a rear limited slip differential, double wishbone front suspension, and a multi-link rear suspension with front and rear stabilizer bars. And running on premium lead gas with a 20.6-gallon fuel tank, it achieves an EPA estimated miles per gallon rating of 13 city, 19 highway, and 0 to 60 times are just under 4 seconds. It also has a special MagnaRide dual mode shock absorber system. Absolutely beautiful power plant. And a long, expansive hood. And you can see where the front top vent opens up into the engine bay. Help keep the area cool. The interior build quality of the California is absolutely phenomenal. This diamond quilted pattern is actually an option from the factory. Everything is wrapped in soft padded leather. Gives a nice smooth soft touch to the entire vehicle pretty much. Your lower storage pockets, color contrast stitching, your power mirrors and power folding mirrors. Both sides of the vehicle. Aluminum door entry guards, fully powered diamond stitched leather seating, full power adjustment for the side bolstering down below and up top with side airbags, imprinted Ferrari logo on the headrest, as well as heated seats. They provide a reasonable amount of comfort and a nice amount of support for those tighter curves. Your trunk and fuel cap release, aluminum sport pedals, as well as a power tilting telescoping steering wheel. You can also see over here the leather stitching for the dash running across the vehicle with the color contrast stitching. So let's go ahead and see how she sounds. quick, freely revving engine. Just as a proper Ferrari should sound. Let's go ahead and put the roof back up. I went ahead and filmed the tour of the passenger side, put the top down so you can get the different perspective. Good shutter up, good solid door veils. Premium audio system with an in-dash navigation mobile media touchscreen interface. Your side curtain airbags. Alcantara lined visor, auto dimming rear view mirror. Up top here, you have your lock and unlock, as well as your interior illumination and reading lamps. Down below, you have a dual zone automatic climate control system, fan speed here, one touch automatic for both sides, air conditioning, rear defrost, front defrost, and independent zone selection for the driver and passenger, and recycling. As far as the navigation system itself, it's pretty simple to use. All of your main options are listed across the side here. Open and close to reveal your compact disc player. It's also DVD compatible. Your seek, changing between your different radio stations or media. It's a hard drive based navigation system, so you can also load up MP3 files. Standard satellite radio.
Give me the taste. Give me the joy of summer wine.
You also have an integrated voice command system. Main menu.
Select one of the following: disk, hard drive, memo, or system setup.
Cancel. Fairly simple to use. It lists all the commands and walks you through it, so you can check it out in there or in your owner's manual. Hands-free telephone.
Phone.
With voice dialing. System menu. Real-time traffic updates through Sirius satellite radio. System setup. Manage your hard drive, phone pairing, voice recognition. Storing your MP3 files as well as picture data. Display settings. That picture right there is what I mean by what you can change. You dual wield your map and your radio data. Audio control, different equalizer settings, and your actual navigation system. Destination input. Points of interest, and so on and so forth. And then your full map screen. USB, auxiliary input, for iPod integration. You can see your beautiful color contrast stitching wrapping around down the center of the vehicle and around aircraft-inspired vents, open and closing. And the stitching also runs across the entire center console. You have a modest amount of storage space here, cup holder, lighter, power outlet. It's also a polished aluminum center console inlay here with the Ferrari logo. Adds a nice amount of touch with an almost suede-like material lining the bottom cubby. You also have your driver selectable performance modes here, selecting for comfort, sport, as well as your more race mode, turning off your traction control and giving you maximum performance. Your automatic wipers, wiper control, your cruise control, all the switches are also metal. And over here, this controls your LCD driver information interface here, the vehicle temperature, as well as oil temperature in this main screen. You hit display, goes between your tire pressure as well as temperature, trip computer, dimmer if you click up and down on the arrow. And now, all of your personalizable options. Car setup. Tire pressure monitoring system, service, and so on and so forth. You also have a digital speedometer as well as your fuel readout with clock and your different suspension setting and outside temperature. Fantastic interior design. So we're going to shut her down. Let's go and check out behind the seat. Moving it forward, the seat automatically grabs it and power slides the seat forward for easier rear seat entry. The back seat is also quite small, which I don't really expect too many people to be sitting in the back seat unless you have a smaller frame, for instance. So let's go ahead and check out the rest of the vehicle, shall we? Large rear hatch and a modest amount of trunk space. Most of it will be taken up by the hard top roof when you fold it down, but you do have usable storage space down below. It's also illuminated, brushed aluminum guards. Side airbags over here in the doors. As well as the same power adjustments on the passenger seat that you find on the driver's. And the seats are rather narrow in the back. Basically a good space for storage unless you're a really small person. Coat hooks on the back of the seat. Your beautiful integrated color contrast stitching going across here. The integrated California badge, padded glove box, and your iPod integration. Alrighty. The California is a perfect blend of performance as well as luxury. Combines the best of both worlds, all with a fantastic Ferrari engine note and head-turning styling. Definitely destined to be a classic. Well guys, I hope you enjoyed this in-depth tour on the 2010 Ferrari California. Be sure to stay tuned next time, there's a lot more where that came from. Take care, everybody.